Alright, this is a little upgrade from last time. Doing a new angle on the stick so you guys can see it going in.
Different veins I can go from. Just use my track mark from last time I stuck myself. Alright. Start with disinfecting the site. Motion starting with the center of the iodine. Start the funnel. My TH catheter, this is my favorite catheter. It's the auto-retracting needle, so you don't need a sharp container right away. Come in, pull intention with my pinky. Anchor the vein at about 30 degree angle. On the skin, on the tree. The initial. Got it. Okay. Insert a little bit more. Very still. Advance the catheter holding with these my pinky, my ring finger. Hold this up here. My thumb and my index are going to slide the catheter into the vein. So it's flush with the skin. Alright. Be very careful about this. I can't use my hand to hold pressure. So. Leave the needle in, get my saline lock ready. Okay. So I press this white button, the needle's gonna retract. I'm gonna bleed a little bit. Plug the vein, the catheter. Bleeding stops, just screw the saline lock in. Now the one I use doesn't have wings. It'd be great if it did, it'd be easier to screw this in. But I'm just screwing in with my middle finger and my index finger. Using my thumb to anchor the catheter. Alright. A little bit of blood, not too bad. Chest pad. I think they're awesome. Alright, I'm going to secure the saline lock with some Tagaderm. We go by a couple different names. This one is Tagaderm now. 3M makes it. Makes it great. Alright, it's just a occlusive dressing. Plastic and sticky. Put right on top of it. Covering the whole thing. Great. Just like the catheter I did before, you don't need to use a sharp container right away. Push it all the way and the needle goes inside the syringe itself. Alright, now let's open up this vein again and give me some fluids. Using a 28. gauge catheter this time because I don't want to waste these ones. These are my favorite. Inspect the needle on the rest duster bars. Like I was saying about the wings earlier, it has like some wings on top of the catheter. Makes it dummy proof. Wipe the side again. Remove the center mass, bevel up. Chamber. I'm going to reopen this port, so normally if I was to give this to somebody, I would hold pressure right here, so no blood would come out, but since I only got one hand to do this, I've got to get in my head that I know I'm going to bleed a little bit. So, get everything ready to go right away. I'm going to pull this needle out. It's going to go right here. Tape handy. So, until next time.